Hi, hello, and welcome. This is Shiva Shankari. On behalf of Don Bosco College of Arts and Science, heartily welcome to all of you present here. A very fine and pleasant morning to all our respected secretary, Reverend Dr. Amla Jayarayan, our honorable principal, Dr. Pais Misia, and our dean, Reverend Father Divya Alex, and our honorable speaker, Dr. A. Ranachitra, assistant professor of computer science at SRNM College, Satur. And my dear Salesians, students, staff, and my dear friends, welcome you all. Education is a matter of the heart. Education is a matter of the heart. Yeah, our Department of Computer Applications is now organizing a national level webinar on a learning management techniques using Canvas Instructure. Now, let's start the session. So before that, without God, nothing is possible in this year. So let's start the program with a prayer song.
Days of love, special these seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior rebel. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing we need.
It's a rich heritage, and it's a customary to welcome everybody in a meeting, and it's our culture also. So let's invite Mrs. Parvata, one woman or me of our department, head of the Department of Computer Applications, to deliver the welcome address. Please, ma'am.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar, Learning Management System Using Canvas Instructure, organized by Department of Computer Application, Don Bosco College of Arts and Science, Kidairal. With utmost sincerity, hearty thanks to the management of DBCAS for being a great pillar behind us and encouraging us at every program. Without their support, we cannot achieve anything. Thanks to the management, and also I welcome them for the webinar. I feel privileged to extend my warm welcome to our Secretary Father Dr. A. Amla Jayarayan, who always endure all our works. Welcome you, Father. Next, I would like to welcome our Principal Dr. S. Pais Misia, who always put a lot of efforts in promoting the knowledge of students. Welcome you, sir. At the outset, I would like to welcome all the Salesians who always assist us like a father and guide us at every stage. I gladly welcome you, all these Salesians. I am very much pleased to welcome our resource person, Dr. A. Ranachitra, Assistant Professor of Computer Science, SRNM College, Satur. It's a great privilege, a pleasure to make such a distinguished person with us today. I warmly welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome our department faculties and other department faculties of our college, who were given support for the better outcome of the program. It's an honor and privilege to give a cordial welcome to all the faculties, research scholars, students from various colleges, and other experts who were much eager in attending this webinar. Hope you will gather many new information through this webinar. Welcome you all. Once again, on the behalf of the management and Department of Computer Applications of DBCAS, welcome you all. Thank you. Over to Shiva, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much, ma'am, for your welcoming. Now, may I now request our college Ramanujam, none other than our principal, Dr. S. Pais Misia, to deliver the presidential address. Please, sir.
Dear respected Reverend Father Amla Jayarayan, Secretary of our college, Reverend Father Alex, Divya Alex, Dean of our college, Reverend Father Charles Anthony, Administrator of our college, Honorable Chief Guest and Resource Person of this webinar, Dr. A. Ranachitra, Department of Computer Science, SRN College, Satur. Dear participants, a very good morning to you all. We extend a warm welcome to you all this webinar, Learning Management System Using Canvas Instructure, organized by Computer Science Department of our Don Bosco College of Arts and Science, Kira. with immense joy and gratitude to God Almighty, I deem it an honor to offer presidential address to this webinar. Our Don Bosco Educational Institution, serving the society throughout the world and widely renowned for quality education that combines knowledge, skills, values, and attitudes, and prepare the youth, especially the poor and downtrodden, for successful career and a meaningful life. Our college is managed and owned by Salesian Fathers of Don Bosco of Trichy Province. In our midst, Dr. A. Ranit Chandra, resource person of this webinar, Learning Management System. I am very happy to introduce her to you all. She is presently working as Assistant Professor of Computer Science Department, SRNM College, Satur. She has a wide, rich teaching experience of 21 years. She is an approved guide of MPhil scholars. She successfully guided 5 MPhil scholars. She has published more research articles in various international and national seminars, and has attended more than 10 conferences and courses. She is the author of 2 books, and she is a member of Board of Studies of various colleges and universities, and he is a program coordinator of various programs organized by various universities and colleges. So with this brief introduction, I am very happy to introduce the resource person to you all. And once again, we extend a warm welcome to all. We wish to express our sincere thanks for the chief guest for her acceptance and to deliver a nice talk for this webinar. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to the faculty of the Department of BCA of our college and our management, especially Reverend Father Secretary, Reverend Father Dean, and Reverend Father Administrators, for their cooperation and guidance extended to us. All the best. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Good morning to everyone. Thank you so much, sir, for the nice introduction and your blessings. It is my pleasure to thank Reverend Father Charles, Reverend Secretary Dr. A. Amala J. Ryan, Principal Dr. S. Payas, Dean Father Divya Alex, Mrs. B. Parvada, Head Department of BCA, and other fathers and Salesians for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share my knowledge with the delegates. I would like to specially thank and congratulate Dr. M. Shivashankari for her constant involvement and dedication to bring this event to this stage. So it's the right time for us, the educator, to move along with the technology to make the learning process as a lifelong learning and anywhere learning and anytime learning. Let us move along. So with this, let us start our session. So let me share the screen. Let me find out whether my screen is visible. Is it okay? Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Somebody can respond so that I can start. Continue.
Ma'am, you can start, ma'am. The screen is visible, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, we are going to start with a learning management system, the Canvas Instructure, which is a free tool which is available in the net. So I have a question. So in the globally and digitally interconnected world, all the learners from the cradle to career need new skills and knowledge to succeed. So is it true? The statement is right. We have to need new skills. Is it right? Yes, we need it. What are the new skills we needed to go with this technology? I'll go with this advancement. What are the skills we need? So as an educator, what we need? As a learner, what they need? So what skills should the learner possess to go with this technology? So some of the skills that is required by the learners are, these are the 21st century skills, the learning skills, literary skills, and life skills. As a learning skills, they need four C's, the critical thinking, creativity, collaboration, and communication. As the term explains the meaning, let me go on to the next one. So the literary skills, this is nothing but the ICT skills, that is information, media, and technology. And the life skills, which gives the skills about the flexibility, leadership, initiative, productivity, and social. So what are these are the skills of the learner. What are the skills that is required as an educator? As we have to possess some skills so that we can cope up with the techie students. So what are the educator skills? So these are the educator skills. These educators has to prepare a material in which each and every participant or learner or actively engaged. Moreover, the educator should be a lifelong learner, and he should have a forward-thinking capacity, and he has to move socially. These are some of the important skills as an educator we should possess so that we can handle the techie learners easily. So why we need these skills? We are going to convert the traditional classroom into the fifth classroom. So traditional classroom is nothing but we'll be delivering the lecture in the classroom. But in the flipped classroom or the technology-based classroom, we are going to provide more activity for the students for engaging, and we'll be guiding them by the side. So we won't give the lecture. We are going to guide them by performing some activity or providing some activity to our students. So we are moving with the technology, and we are converting the lecture method into an activity method. So for this, we need an e-content. So what is e-content? E-content is nothing but an electronic content which includes a text, images, graphics, animation, audio, and video. These e-content, once it has been prepared, it can be transferred to anywhere with the help of the internet. So what will be the benefits of the e-content? Whatever e-content has been prepared should be student-centric. So it should be very interactive so that we can actively engage our participants. And it should be accessed anywhere and anytime. And the material what we have prepared should be based on the need of the student. And especially it should be accepted, or it will be actively participation for the challenge students also. So with this, we are going to prepare the e-content. While we are going to prepare the e-content, we need four quadrants. As the UGC has suggested, we need four quadrants. The first quadrant should be the text information. It can be called as a e-text. And that text can be created with a rich text box format, or DOC format, or OTD format. And it can have at least a minimum of 8 pages and a minimum of 3,000 words. And the second quadrant will be audio information or a video information. And the duration of the video should be 30 minutes in chunks of 7 to 8 minutes. And the format should be MP4 format. And the next quadrant, 4-3, will be the resources what we are going to provide. It can be the materials, or it can be the notes, it can be the books, articles, journal papers, or whatever it may be. Or it can be directly a links to the websites. And the last quadrant, which is for the interactive session for the student or the learner, it can have a quiz question or the multiple choice question, and even a match it, or even a true or false questions. And it can have a minimum of 10 to 15 questions so that we can find whether the learners are actively participating, and we can grade it in the online itself. So I have found out so many tools available in the net, and these are some of the tools which can be used for preparing a basic e-content. The first one is a Canvas Instructure, which is a learning management system, what we are going to see today. And the next one is a ThingLink, which is used for annotating the images with audios, videos, web links. And the Quizlet is similar to the quiz app what we create with the help of the Google Forms. The next one is a Google Form. GIMP is nothing but an image editing software which can be used to edit the image, and we can include in our web content. Audacity is nothing but we can record our audio, and we can edit our audio and place it in our web content. And the next one is A Power Soft Screen Recorder, is for capturing the video. The only drawback with this is we cannot edit the video what we have prepared with this ASR screen recorder. And the next one is a Padlet, which is similar to the notice board what we have in our department. And this one is used to display the information about the topic or the course or whatever it is, it will be displayed in the Padlet. And the voice thread is nothing but if you want to annotate an image, PPT or videos, we can make use of this voice thread. These are the some of the tools that can be included in our e-content development. And these are available free in the net and we can use it and we can prepare a wonderful e-content for the learner community. So today we are going to start with the Canvas instructure. What is Canvas instructure? It is a learning management system which provides the support for both the teachers and the learners. We as an educator will be providing some materials, videos, audios, or even a PPTs in our e-content. And then after providing the materials, we can conduct quiz or ask them to submit the assignments. Both the quiz and the assignments will be graded with the help of the tool itself. And one particular thing is it is really available and it has no time limit. We can open whenever we require that Canvas instructure. And this Canvas instructure is not specifically for the particular classroom or particular class of students. It can be publicly available and it can be accessed worldwide. Our material will be available for everyone in this world who wants to view our material. Only thing is we have to post it. So what is the difference? We might be familiar with the Google Classroom. What is the difference between the Canvas and the Google Classroom? Yeah, the Google Classroom, what we have created or what we will be using will be shared only with a particular class or a particular student. So with this classroom, if you want to conduct any quiz, we have to depend upon the external event or the external entity, that is the Google Forms, to conduct the quiz and import the results to our Google Classroom. So with this Canvas, I can prepare a quiz questions and that questions will be participated by or completed by the participants or the learners, and it will be posted in the Canvas itself. No need for our external agent to evaluate the question and the assignment. And here with the Canvas, we have more interactive components, and which will make the learners an active participation, which is nothing but the activity based learning. So which come with the flipped classroom. So this Canvas have more facilities. We'll see one by one so that we'll be familiar with this. I can also compare this Canvas with this Google Classroom then and there. So together we are going to create the future. So let us start with the Canvas material or the worksheet. So here, if anybody is working with a laptop, we can open the Google. So let me stop sharing here and open the So here I have opened the Google Chrome. Here let us type Canvas instructure. It is freely available in the net. If anybody wants to work with me, you can start typing Canvas instructure in the Google address bar. It will be displayed with a link. The first link, Canvas by instructure, is the correct link. You click over it. Once you open this Canvas instructure, you will be displayed with a dashboard. The list of courses what we have published. So to create an account for this Canvas instructure, we have to have a Gmail account. So I'll explain that too. Log out first and let me start from the scratch. So this is a login screen for the Canvas. So if I have a Gmail account, that is enough. Otherwise, I can make use of the Facebook or the LinkedIn or Twitter, whatever it is possible. Or I can also directly click a mail ID with the help of the need Canvas account. Since I have a Gmail account, I'm just clicking this Gmail and logging into the Canvas instructure. Once I have logged in, is my screen visible? Hello, ma'am. Is my screen visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Yes, ma'am. Your screen is visible, ma'am. You carry on, ma'am.
So once we have logged in to the Canvas instructor, we'll be displayed with a starting screen, that is the dashboard. This dashboard contains the courses what I have created and published. These are the courses I have published. And if I have created something and then if I have not published the course, it will be displayed as an unpublished course. Okay. And if you want to enroll in these courses or other courses, or what, if you want to see the other courses that is published in this Canvas, we can click on this courses link. So these are the some of the courses I have prepared, published courses, unpublished courses, and these are the courses that is already created and published the Canvas by the other educators. I can enroll here. These are the some of the courses that is available public. I can click on it and I can enroll automatically in this, as we do in the NPTEL courses and the SWAYAM course. Okay. So now it's the time to start creating the new courses. So I have again moved on to the dashboard. In this dashboard, I find the published courses. Now we are going to start a new course. Just click on this start new course, which is available on the right side of your screen. Start a new course. The first step is, here we are going to provide the name of the course what we are going to create. Let it be e-content. Once I have provided the course name, I can set the license for this course what I am going to create. So it can be private, which means that I'm going to share this course only for a particular group of students, not for the others. If I want to make it as a public, once I have created a full-fledged course which includes all the components, I can make it as a public one. It is available in the public domain. So since I'm going to start from the scratch, let me create it as private. After creating the entire course, I can publish it as a public course. So just click on this create course. Initially make it as private. After creating the complete course, we can make it as a public one. So this is the starting page what we'll be having. So here we have started with the dashboard. We entered the courses, which means that we are just going to start creating our course. So this course consists of many modules, and each and every module can have any number of items. So let me start adding the module. Let it be unit 1. The unit 1 is the first module what I am going to add. So this module, once I have added this module, so this module what we have created can be locked until a particular time period. For example, if I am going to launch my course here, and the student should be able to see the course only by the end of this first week of July, I can lock here until June 30, and it will be unlocked on July 1st. This I can provide here. So this is what we'll be getting in the NPTEL course also. We can lock and unlock the courses. Here I'm going to do nothing. I'm moving on, just adding this module. So here, the first module, the name of the first module is unit 1, has been added. So with this module, this button indicates that whether we are going to publish this module or not. If I click this, it will turn to green color, which means that this module has been published. Even though somebody is waiting in the wait room, I admit it. So here, with this module, once this module has been published, we had to publish this course too. even somebody is raising the hand. Hello.
Ma'am, we will handle the question answer at the end of the session, ma'am.
If we are clear the doubts at the initial stage, then later the things they can be doing like themselves.
Okay, ma'am.
For the initial queries to be clear, so that they
okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Please wait. We will unmute them, ma'am. Okay. Yaar hand raise panni panga paaru avangala potu unmute podu. Ma'am, she is not available now, ma'am.
Oh,
next time we will handle, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. So we have created the module, and we can publish this module. Once the module has been published, it will be available for access for the participants. Even though the module has been published, we have to publish the course so that the course will also be available. Okay. We'll start adding items to this module. The first module, unit one. Let me add the item. After preparing the entire module, let us publish this course. Okay. For adding this item, just click this plus symbol. So this is the items we are going to add to unit one. So this unit, this item, what are the four important modules of this unit? Are the modules quiz, page, discussion, and file. These are the four important things we will be trying to add for a basic e-content development. So let us start with the page. Let it be some introduction. A new page has been added. The name of the page is introduction. Add item. So here, unit one, within this module, I have an item introduction. So let us add some text to this introduction. So click on this. So you'll be displayed with a title introduction. Here, I can click this edit button to add the text information to the items. So this is the screen where we are going to type the text information, or an image, or a link, or upload a file, a PDF, or whatever thing that is required to be shared as a material for the learner, we can do it here. So here we have five important tools. The first one is the rich content editor. This is the rich content editor. Here, it is similar to a text box, multi-line text box. Here we can type whatever is needed as an introduction section. So let it the text. So we can bold this text. We can perform any type of editing what we need. We can change the color of the text as we do here. Okay. And if you want to add any bullets, which is similar to the word processing, we can add it here with the help of the bullets. Or we can also make use of this numbering format, which is similar to the word processor or a MS Word. And if you want to add any mathematical formula, you can make use of this one, insert math equation, which will be displayed with another screen. So I can add a information alpha plus beta is equal to some gamma. That's it. So this is how I can add it, and I can just press insert equation so that it will be inserted in the current position. So this is the formula. This is how. Let me repeat this. For inserting a math equation, click on this symbol. It'll be displayed with the screen. Here we have different types of operators: a relation operator, and then arrows, a delimiters, and the basic operators. Here we can make use of a pi symbol, a sigma symbol. Therefore, these are the some of the symbols that can be added, and you can just press the insert equation to add it to here. So here I can add a table also. So this is how we can add the table. Some 4x4 table, and here I can provide the heading. With this table, I can perform all the editing options, which is similar to the MS Word. This module, we have created this with the help of the rich content editor. The next tool is the HTML editor. Once I have prepared this, we will be preparing the text or adding the text information or any item that is required with the help of this one, rich content editor. If you want to see the HTML format of this page, what we have created, I can click on this. This is the HTML file for the thing what we have created, ordinary HTML text. If you are well versed with the HTML tag, we can make use of this HTML editor to perform or create the e-content text information. Otherwise, we can directly move on with this HTML editor where we can type the things which is similar to the Word. So which will be easy for us. So this one will be very familiar, so we can make use of this one. And the next important tool for this Canvas module is these three tools. The first one is a rich content editor. The second one is the HTML editor, then links, files, and images. So for this, after adding these information, we'll be creating a next item for adding these files and images. So after adding these information, these things can be set. Only the teachers can edit this. Pages. Yes, only the teachers can edit this. If you want the student to edit, we can add it to the students also. Just save this. So this is the page what we have created. Again, move on to the course. Now we are trying to add another module or an item to the same module. So first let me add an item. To add an item, just press this plus in this module. This one is used to add the item, and this one is used to add a module. This is module. Let me name it as unit 2. If you want any prerequisites for entering into this unit 2, we can set it. For this, we can set it as we have to complete unit 1 and we have to move on to unit 2. If nothing is required, just press add module. Yeah, second module has been added here. So let me add an item to this second module. Plus. So now let us add a PPT or a PDF file to this module. So to add a PPT or a PDF file, I can make use of this file option. A new file will be added. Click on this new file and choose the file. First, let us add a PDF file. Okay. So the file has been uploaded here. Add that item. So here the file has been added. So this one, this PDF can be downloaded by clicking the link, or it can be viewed here itself. So I can also add the item with the help of the add item click on this plus. Add an item, a new page. Let me name it as PDF file or materials. Add the item. So click on this material. I'm going to edit this material. Edit here. So here I can make use of this tag also to add a file. So let me use this tag today to add a file. Upload a new file. Choose a file. Now let us add a PPT. It has been opened. Just click save. So we have created the modules, unit 1 and unit 2, and we have added introduction item and materials item in unit 1 and a PDF file in unit 2. So this modules has to be published. So just click on this button to publish it. So the individual items and the modules has been published. So the entire course has to be published here. Before publishing the course, let us find how the student will be visible viewing this course when they enroll this course. For this, we can check with the student view. So the first one, this is a student view. They can just only view this information. Unit 1. So it is an introduction. So these are the information what we have added. Just click on this next to view the next item. The materials. Just we have added nothing. So just click on the next item. This is the PDF file where we can download this PDF, or it will be displayed here also. This is the one what we can read here. In the screen itself, it will be displayed. If you want to make it as a full screen view, also we can also view it, or we can download it and later we can read it. So these are the information what we have added here. Full screen view. This is the full screen view. Press escape to move on to this. And if you want to leave the student view, just click on this, leave the student view and move on to the original screen or where we have created our information. That is the text information. And if you want to add an image to your e-content, move on to the course home. Let me add another item. New page. Page for images. Add item. So edit this. Press edit. So I can make use of this button, images button, to upload a new image. So likewise, we can create whatever content is needed. Now we have added a text information, we have added a PDF, we have tried to add a PPT, and we have tried to add an images. So these are the things that is essential for a particular e-content we are going to create. So if we want to add a quiz, that is the important thing, what we need, which is a unique one with this canvas. So let me add a separate module for this quiz. If you want to lock it, we can lock it. Be connected. Just a minute. Add a module. The module has been added. Here I am going to add an item. Request is added. New quiz. I can hear basic question. Add this item. So here the quiz item has been added. Click on this basic question to edit that. So this is the initial screen. Click on here, edit. So these are the details what we are going to provide. It may be some instruction to the learner. Five points or 5 marks. These are the some of the instruction what we can give it for the learners. So this is a graded quiz. Yes, it is a graded quiz. If you want to shuffle the answer, we can shuffle it here. If you want to set any time limit, we can set it here. Since it is for the trial version, I'm just skipping these questions. And if you want to make it available only for the particular time period, we can make it here. And if you want to provide the correct answers only on a particular duration, we can provide here in this. So it has been assigned to everyone. And this quiz will be available in this date, from this particular date to this particular date. So just save it. So here we have provided these information. Now we have to provide the questions. I can click on edit. Instruction is over. The next one is we are going to provide the questions. Click on this button, questions. Add a new question. It can be a multiple choice question, a true or false question, fill in the blanks, or a matching question, or whatever maybe. Can be also a essay question also. Let me start with the multiple choice question. The first question, www. The first option is for providing the correct answer. So if you want to provide any explanation, I can click here and provide the explanation. The second one is for the wrong choice. If you want to add another addition, I can also use. So here also I can provide a comment for the correct answers. For example, you are correct. The comments can be provided here. Your answer is correct. Answer is correct. If you want to provide anything for the general comments, I can provide here. If you want to provide anything for the wrong answer also, I can provide here. The first question has been added, and the second question. Let it be true or false question. Computer is an electronic machine. So it will be true or it can be false. So update this question, save it. So now we have to publish. We can preview before publishing it. Preview. So www stands for World Wide Web. Computer is an electronic machine. It's true. Submit the quiz. Here I have not changed the points. If I have changed it, it will be 5. Submit the quiz. Okay. Points, 2 points. Both the questions are correct. So I have been awarded with 2 out of 2. If you want to change the quiz, we can also change the points and the questions also. Let me click on this edit. Question. I have to change this one. Get it? 1.5 points. Get it? 5 points. So the questions has been added. Next, let us start with an assignment, which is an important content for our learner community. Click on this as a new module for new item, assignment, new assignment. Let it be. Yes, impact of add item. So click here to edit this. Edit. For this question, these are the things I can provide the marks here or the points here. It is available for the student community. So how they are going to submit the assignment? This is an online submission. Whether they are going to make use of a text entry, a website URL, or a recording, or a file uploads. So I can make use of these file uploads. And if you want to restrict the file size or the file type, I can make use of this restrict file upload. Just say these are the file components, important components that has to be added to this canvas instructure. And then important thing is how to enroll the people. So for this, let me stop after completing the enrollment. Go to settings. So here I can provide the course image. You just go through the settings where the explanation is given at the each and every comments for this item. Here the course starts on date and the ends date. The students can participate only within these two dates. So I'm just keeping these information. This is private. So you click on this more option. You let the student self-enroll by sharing them the secret URL code. Just click this and update the. So this is the URL we are going to share with the students. Click this URL, paste it in a Word file, or paste it in your WhatsApp group or in a Google Classroom, so that they can click this link to enroll this course. This is a self-enrollment for the students. If you want each and every individual to be added by the instructor, I can make use of this people. Link as people. The people link is used to add a set of people, a group of people or individual student by clicking this people. So the entire course can be created by adding more number of modules and more items. A quiz can be added. An assignment can be posted. And this is how you can add the people to this course. Let me cancel this. And one important thing is how to add a discussion forum or a feedback session for our course what we have created. Click on a module. Let it be feedback. The last item of this webinar, feedback. Click on this feedback. Edit this discussion. Any topics can be provided here, add item. So provide your suggestions related to the course. So here we will be typing the information. This is the author information. We can make it as Android information. We can move on here, or we can just type the comment and we can send it. The learner can type the information and we can send it. And we can also attach a file as a discussion forum too. So these are the information, important things that is related to the Canvas instructure. Hope we have gathered some information. If you have any doubts, you can raise your questions here. Let me stop here. It is not possible. So each and every module and item has been published. The course has to be published here. A full-fledged course is now created and it is made available for the students to enroll by themselves or by the instructor. So hope you enjoyed this session. Any queries here? Shall I stop sharing the screen?
Excuse me, the participants, if you have any queries, you can type in your chat box and the resource person would answer.
Excuse me, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning.
Ma'am, I am Ms. Rajalakshmi. மேம் லேப்டாப்ல மட்டும் தான் கிரியேட் பண்ண முடியுமா மொபைல் ஃபோன் யூஸ் பண்ணியும் கிரியேட் பண்ண முடியுமா
நீங்க மொபைல் ஃபோன் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம் ஆனா என்னன்னா ஸ்கிரீன் வந்து உங்களுக்கு வந்து ফুল ஸ்கிரீன் வியூ கிடைக்காது நீங்க ஸ்க்ரோல் பண்ணி ஒவ்வொரு ஐட்டம் மாடியூலையும் நீங்க பண்ற மாதிரி இருக்கும் But whenever you make use of this laptop, it will be very easy and you'll be familiar with the each and every item that will be displayed in the screen.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, one more, ma'am. Quiz la vandu nama questions vera engayadhu type panni vechitta adha inga file la import panna ma'am.
Kandipa. Neenga word file la type panni vechitinga na anga vandu copy panni neenga inga paste pannikalam.
Oh, yes ma'am, yes ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Neenga net la irundhu download panni neenga use pannna kuda neenga use pannikalam.
Thank you ma'am.
நம்ம Google Classroom க்கு இதுக்கு உள்ள டிஃபரன்ஸ் Google Classroom we can directly conduct a quiz for that we have to depend on Google Forms here we can directly create a quiz the question can be added either from the net or whatever we have prepared can be added to this instruction
thank you so much ma'am
thank you
ஆமா சைக்கிள் அனுமா ஓட்டற மாதிரி ரெடி பண்ணி கொடுங்க
ஹலோ சார்
இஸ் இட் பாசிபிள் டு கிரியேட் எஸ்ஏ டைப் क्वेश्चंस to conduct yeah. essay type test do you have an option
yes ma'am it is possible while we are adding this question quiz assignment question there is an option whether
instead of quiz essay type is possible
yeah yes ma'am it can be created as a quiz and a short essay a short answers or an essay can be provided by the learner I have an shown the option to the quiz match it fill in the prompts and the short
answer audible
ma'am ma'am good morning ma'am this is Sophia ma'am
yes ma'am
ma'am I am the session was very good and informative ma'am
ma'am
I have a doubt shall we upload videos ma'am
yeah definitely it is a file which can be uploaded while okay, you are going to add a video click on this item as a file okay. there you can upload an audio file a video file a ppt or a pdf
video audio ppt ellathayum
hello
Yeah, everything can be added. Before that, Madam Ramya, I hope so.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, madam. நீங்க mute பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னு நினைக்கிறேன்.
Hello, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Can I add a co-teacher here?
I can get you, sir.
Hello?
Hello.
Can I add a co-teacher in this module?
What is it? Sir, I can get it.
Can I add co-teacher?
Co-teacher.
Co-teacher.
Yeah.
Co-teacher, yes, we can add a co-teacher, but the teacher cannot be editing. If you are providing the option, you have an option that a student can edit. There you can add a teacher as a student and they can edit, not other student. That is the only possibility here. But in Google Classroom, we can add a teacher. Here we can add a teacher for editing or adding the content only with the help of the student name. Here the course is only for a single
teacher. Okay. Unmute.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Hope you have enjoyed the session very much.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So far, you see the feedback link to us.
So don't worry, participants. It will be posted by our email or any other telegram link thank you so much ma'am now let me invite reverend father charles it's a father of our department also you are the what of thank
the impact of corona is very huge and it is affecting every field especially the teachers and students and now the teachers are actually forced to learn lot of LMS tools and it is also one of the kind of workshops that we are conducting to learn this LMS based on using Canvas Instructure and we are many of us are using different learning management systems And I really sincerely thank the resource person, Dr. Rani Chitra, the assistant professor, for having really exhausted the usage of Canvas Instructure, the learning management system using Canvas Instructure. Is really demonstrated with a lot of illustrations how to create classrooms, courses, add teachers, students, and create e-quiz, how to award, etc. So it is really a very helpful webinar for all the teachers, I believe. So once again, I thank the resource person as well as the principal, the patron of our college, the Reverend Father Secretary, and the convener and the staff and collaborators of the webinar. So sincerely thank all the participants also for your interactive participation. Many of you were keenly watching as well as watching it through YouTube's and asking questions through chat box. The link will be available in the YouTube channel. Later on, you can watch, and the feedback link will be given to you as soon as the session is over now. So continue to keep in touch with the YouTube channel. You will get the resources offline also. So thank you once again. Thank you.